Welcome back to the Everywhere Communications YouTube channel. This will be following up on the last video where we talked about the introduction to the Geofence feature. Today we're going to be talking about actually how to create the Geofences and how to make sure that those are applied to the appropriate devices on your team. So right away we're going to start on the Geofence tab here on the hub. If you want to look back at my old video, which would be the Geofence introduction video, that is where you'll be able to find out how to actually locate this Geofence feature. I'm going to zoom in on one of my existing Geofences, and I'm going to show you how to overlay a new Geofence over that existing one. You can see the blue plus button in the bottom right. You're going to select the blue plus button when you are happy with the approximate area where you'd like that Geofence to be. So you can see I'm going to select the blue plus button in the bottom right. A boundary appears on the map. Now I have the ability to customize the exact shape and size of this Geofence, and you can see that you are able to overlay that Geofence boundary over the existing one. You can use all these different anchor points. Every time I create the anchor point, it's going to create two new anchor points so that you can further customize the exact shape of that polygon Geofence. Once you are happy with the shape and size, you can see over here in the top left, you are able to customize the name for that Geofence. I'm going to label this test fence. And you can see I can also toggle on what types of alerts I'd like to receive. So you can receive alerts both on entry and on exit, or one or the other. Once I'm happy with what type of setup I want for alert notifications, I'm going to hit save. And now you can see that that is going to be labeled test fence. If I want to edit that, I can always go back into the Geofence feature tab and always edit that shape and make sure that it's the exact size and shape that I want it to be, and always hit save. If you want to copy these fences over onto the other team members on your folder structure, what you're going to do is select down here, copy fences. When I select copy fences, it's going to bring open our team hierarchy. And team hierarchy, you'll note, is going to be a future video that we're looking to release very soon, where it's going to be talking about team setup and team configuration. So right now I can either search for a device. So if I want this to be applied to a specific device, I could type in, let's say for this instance, our other YouTube star, Tim Fallon. You can see that his name will appear here. Otherwise, I can actually pull open the folder structure by selecting the tree here, and you can see the various different folder structures that will appear, and I can actually apply this across all my different team members, and I hit okay. That will now apply all those Geofences to all the devices on my team. As always, please comment below and subscribe. Anytime you want to make any comments, just make sure you comment with any future videos that you would like to see from us and our team. As always, appreciate you coming here and watching this video. The next video I'll be working on will be talking about how to import Polygon Geofences using Google Earth. Really excited to release that video and looking forward to seeing you there soon. Thanks.